Hello, hello. Is everything working? It seems everything is working, yes. Hi, my name is Athena Bear, and welcome to my channel. Today is my first game video. I'm gonna play a game called DREAMTALE by Cory Reiko on Game Yall. This game is a free game you can play on browser. So I thought this game would be a great start. So, a little bit about the game first. This is post-pacifist ending. I don't know if it's true pacifist or just pacifist. And the game can run from 5 to 20 minutes depending on how much oneself explore. Yeah. And the game was released 4 years ago. No, it says 3 years ago here. I'm wondering why myself, but anyways, let's begin. I can't put on full screen yet. This game is made by Unity. Alright. Drink a little water. There we go. Oh, made with Unity. It's lagging a little. I guess that's because of my computer. Oh! I really like music. It's really good. Can I put on full screen now? Yeah, I can. So, DREAMTALE. I press C to begin. Yeah. Oh, excuse me. see. Okay. See. Okay. We are on a bed of golden flower. Oh, I can go here. Okay. Can I interact with flowers? Oh yeah, I can! Golden flowers. Floating on nothing. Golden flowers. Floating on nothing. Seems there's nothing here then. I can't interact with the road. I can't interact with those sparkly things either. Seems that it's a bridge. Alright, let's see. I don't know why, but the car just stopped itself when I was pushing forward. And now there's an open passage. I don't want to go there because it's all, it looks like the gates of heaven. How they like, don't go to the light! Is there another way? Can I go past it? No. I can't walk past it, so it seems I have to go in. Maybe there's another way now? No. Seen that way. Very well, I shall go to the door. By the way, first of all, does anyone know what this song is from? Like, if it's only for this game or if it's from the normal games too? I don't remember, but this song is really good. Right on that room. Oh, sorry. By the way, one thing, everyone, before I continue,
I'm gonna interact with everything I can interact with. Just so you know, in case you think it's getting a little long, but I'm gonna interact with everything. Maybe why this video will be longer. I don't know how long this video will be. It depends on how much you can interact with stuff. So, let's begin interacting. Can't seem to get back to sleep. This handsome, solemn quilt has kept you warm and cozy for the past few months. Aww. You still feel quite awake. A little walk might be nice.
Yeah, I think so too.
Can't seem to get back to sleep.
Okay, it seems that it's, gonna be the same thing. I pressed X and the full text popped up. So I guess, right, X was, you could skip. So the full dialogue would pop forward. I think it was in normal game too. Let's see.
It's a clothes dryer. There are many clean striped shirts. The lower drawer holds mementos of your journey. You shuffle through the lower drawer. It's a stick. You shuffle through the lower drawer. It's a used bandage.
Disgusting.
Ew.
Sorry, that was disgusting. Oh, they even said ew themselves.
Ew.
Yeah, that's pretty disgusting. Shouldn't you have thrown that away by now?
I don't throw away stuff. I'll keep it.
Alright. Oh, excuse me. I'm a little bit, yawny.
You shove it through the lower dryer. It's a toy knife. You shove it through the lower dryer. Huh? The faded ribbon is missing.
What? Where's the ribbon? I'm gonna look forward. Maybe I can find it in the house.
You shuffle through the lower dryer. It's a tough glove. You shuffle through the lower dryer. It's a manly bandana. Very manly indeed. You shuffle through the lower dryer. It's a pair of ballet shoes. You shuffle through the lower dryer. It's an old tutu. You shuffle through the lower dryer. It's a torn notebook. There's some sad stuff written inside. You shuffle through the lower dryer. It's a pair of cloudy glasses. You shuffle through the lower dryer. It's a burnt pen. You shuffle through the lower dryer. It's a stained apron. You could probably clean this stain off somehow.
Yeah, but that would ruin the memento. Cause you found it like that, right?
Yeah. You shove it through the lower dryer. It's an empty gun.
You have an empty Glock. Or gun. In your drawer.
Okay.
I will not judge you.
Toya would not like to see this dryer.
Nope, she would not. She would take that gun away. She would probably throw it away even.
Child, what do you have there? Oh my gosh, it's not a gun. No.
And she would pass out.
You shuffle through the lower dryer. It's a worn dagger.
You even have a dagger? What the fuck?
You shuffle through the lower dryer. Oh! It's the heart locket. Best friends forever. Well, that's all of them. Mementos are nice, but so is the rest of the house. Mementos are nice, but so is the rest of the house.
Yeah. I guess so.
Oh, it's a beautiful night outside. It's a beautiful night outside. Birds are sleeping, flowers are blooming.
Are they gonna do continue the speech, but make it about night time?
Yep, a beautiful night.
Nope, we're not gonna continue. I thought we were gonna do like
on nights like these, kids like me should be sleeping.
I thought they were gonna do something like that.
It's a beautiful night outside.
Yeah. Okay, that's probably everything.
It's just a lamp. It's not even conveniently shaped.
No! How could they?
It's just a lamp. It's just a lamp.
Where is our conveniently shaped lamp? Oh, that way I can dance. Can I drive through the wall? Oh, I can drive through the wall.
I feel like this hallway used to be a little longer in underground.
It was? Feel like that's the only thing I can say. Yeah. Okay, so is this a little longer? I'm gonna look that up later. No. I accidentally went into the room. Can I talk to the flower here?
It's a lovely red flower, finally growing, with a little help. It's a lovely red flower. Toriel's room. It's locked. Toriel's room. It's locked. Okay.
Oh my god. We've been infiltrated. By Mr. Puns himself. By Mr. Puns. He's probably gonna do the speech just like we did at the window.
Birds are sleeping, flowers are blooming. On nights like these, kids like you should go to sleep.
Oh, looks like someone has been having fun with a chalkboard. Oh no, it's Puns! Lots of puns! Nothing but puns! The chalkboard is filled with awful skeleton jokes.
Yeah. We got Sans the Master. Master Sans, master of puns.
It's a lovely yellow flower.
I almost forgot to talk to this flower.
It's a lovely yellow flower. It's a lovely red flower.
Oh,
it's saying the same thing as the other red flower. Okay, I won't judge.
It's a water sausage. Toriel has been growing these, along with her many other beautiful flowers. A simple water sausage. Simple water sausage. But aren't there two sausages? Toriel gave you this weird looking stuffed animal, but she uses more than you do. Keeping hallways safe and beds warm. Room under renovation. I wanna go inside. Oh, it's a basket of shirts, all with the same pattern. Fashion. Fashionable shirts. Fashionable shirts. Oh, wait.
Oh, this is the end of the hallway. I just noticed that, no. So let's go back. Yeah! Now when I... Oh, I accidentally went into the room again. Now when I think about it, I do think the hallway was a little longer. This room was a little further away, and there was, I think there was a big mirror here. Yeah, I think so. Anyways, let's continue.
I don't know why, but music is making me a little bit sleepy.
So sorry if my commentary sound a little weird. I will be drinking a little water now. I can't interact with the bookshelf? Oh, I pressed the wrong button.
Almost all these books are new surface literature. Smells like fresh print. Smells like fresh print.
Alrighty then. Let's take a picture of that. Oh. That was in my phone. I have it on loading.
Smells like fresh print.
One second. I'll take a picture of that. There we go. I have a plan for this already. So yeah, let's begin. Continue on it. Can I? Oh, nope. Nothing new.
It's a painting of the Delta Room. It's a painting of the Delta Room.
Oh, okay.
It's a vase of particularly lovely tulips. I checked the vase again, just in vase. A vase of particularly lovely tulips.
Should I go downstairs, go here, or go up? I go outside. I see how that. Oh. Okay, I hear the wind. Okay. Oh,
it's a glowing mushroom from the underground. It's a glowing mushroom from the underground.
Okay. Oh! What the fuck?
No! No! Grab the book! What the fuck?
Why am I standing on you?
Ooh! Oh, hi, Frisk. I was just sleeping here, outside your house. But then I went. I stepped on the underside of your shoe. I'm so sorry.
You didn't step on me, I stepped on you! My adorable little ghost.
Ghost boy, oh my gosh.
Are you having trouble sleeping? You can hang out here with me if you want to. Or not. You can try to sleep on the dirt too, but you might catch a cold out here. Though I am sometimes mistaken for a bedsheet, I am still not a very good blanket.
Oh gosh, I'm not gonna step on you.
I also stepped on Toriel when she walked out tonight. It seemed like there was something on her mind. I'm not so good at entertaining, I don't really know any snail facts either. Do you want to hear some spooky facts instead? No? Oh, okay.
I would love to hear your spooky facts. Blooky, talk to me. I want to know everything.
If you really want to get some sleep, you could always do what I do. Just relax, stay perfectly still, and think about the whole galaxy. Just try not to feel like garbage. Well, I'll be here. Doing that. Well, I'll be here. Well, I'll be here. Oh, could it be that you really do want to hear my spooky facts after all? This one is more of a spooky yoke, really. Okay, here it goes.
What do you call a parent's mom and dad? A girl's mom and dad. Trans parents. Aww. Oh. That's a wonderful joke. I'm sorry. How did the ghost learn to make music? He read sheet music. It's very windy now here. It's okay if you want to go back inside now. I understand. When does a ghost make his breakfast? In the morning. Ooh. What is a ghost's favorite music type? It's soul music. Sorry, Chris. I really don't have any more. Well, I'll be here all night. Okay, it seems that Nathalie doesn't have any more to say, so let's go talk to these. It's a glowing mushroom from the underground. I'm sorry, but I thought... Oh, I thought I heard footsteps. Loki, you may come inside if you want to.
Well, I'll be here all night.
Please, Loki, follow me inside. I am fucking scared of being outside here. I thought I heard footsteps in the forest. Come with me. Now. I guess he doesn't want to follow me. Okay. We go downstairs now. Yes, because Toria didn't want you to go downstairs in Undertale. See how it looks. Oh. I would love to have Loki with me. Like, he... I'm going back to him. He has something more to say now. He's just gonna say the same thing. We don't know. Loki. Loki! He's standing up! Oh, you're still awake? I hope you aren't getting sick. I would offer you a goodnight hug, but, you know. Sweet dreams, Frisk. Sweet dreams, Frisk. Oh, sweet dreams, you too, my little Blookster. Yes. Oh! Why is Nathalie look so cute? I think Nathalie looks real cute. Yeah.
Under construction.
Okay. It would be fun, like, if you could take an option and say, like, hey, come with me. Come inside. You can be with me inside, how? And we can talk. Oh. Okay. Can't I interact with this? Oh, now I can.
You take a piece of candy. It's your house, so you get to take as much as you want. You took more candy. How delicious. You take another piece. You reveal in the fact that there are no deep, meaningful consequences to these actions. You take another piece. Yum. You take another piece. Yum.
Okay. That was all? I wonder if they're like, we can find a good time these? Or do anything? I can't interact with them, so.
I've seen you around, little ducky.
Aw, this duck is just adorable. He's adorable too. Like, just look at him. Or her. Or them. They. I don't know what you want to call.
This duck is happy to see you. Or maybe just doing a little dance.
And maybe you pet the duck. It quacks happily.
There's a distinct possibility that this duck is a good boy. You pet the duck. It quacks. You quack back. You pet the duck. It nuzzles closely up to your hand. You pet the duck. It's so warm and soft. You pet the duck. It loves you unconditionally. You pet the duck. It loves you unconditionally.
I love you too, ducky. I love you. I'm gonna dance with the ducky. I can't dance that good. I can't dance as good as you, my friend.
A pair of glowing mushrooms on the underground.
It would be funny if I could bring them along. Both Master Bloke and the little ducky. It would be wonderful. I see an echo flower.
A pair of glowing mushrooms on the underground.
What do you have to say?
It's so heavy!
Papyrus? You hear, man? Is Papyrus here? What? Wait, maybe there's more.
It's so heavy! Loves you unconditionally.
I just had to go to the duck and see again if there was something new. I'm sorry. Okay, let's continue. Oh no. Wait. Why is he sparkling? I see seas and then I see the sparkles behind him? I don't want to wake him up though, but he probably won't wake up, I guess. Let's see what he has to say anyways.
Aww, looks like he's all tuckered out. You poke him gently.
Huh?
No response. You rattle his bones. Still nothing. Sense is deep in slumber. You're a little bit jealous of his sleeping skills. Sleeping well. Sleep well. Some lily pads and water sausages decorate this quaint little water feature.
It is kind of quaint. Yeah. Oh. Hey, be careful carrying that. This is really important to her. What is important for her? You're talking about my mother.
It's a glowing mushroom from the underground. Toria seems to be growing her very own voltage sausages. Toria seems okay. Should we put a second tone back here? Down back here.
Yeah, you should just set it down back there, Papyrus.
You hear the faint sound of some happy squeaks. It seems a little friend lives here.
Aww. And then we have this wonderful statue.
Oh, this old statue. Looks like someone finally salvaged it from down the ground. Lose your umbrella, old friend.
Just a second.
Oh, 1 second. I'll be right back.
Sorry about that. Come on. There we go. Here we go. Alright. 11 minutes ago. 10% of the battery left. But I looked earlier and it said like it had over 2 hours. You haven't gone over 2 hours, right? Anyways, I'm back. So let's continue the adventure.
It's a weather statue from deep within the waterfall's caverns.
I wonder what he has behind him, because there is something sparkling there? Or is it just him being very fabulous? I don't know. Let's go.
No! Ducky! Ducky, duck, no! The duck is crying because he missed you so much. You pet the duck and tells him everything so it'll be alright. You pet the duck. And he still loves you.
I love you too. Oh my god. Oh my gosh, I'm so sorry, little ducky. Oh my gosh. Oh my god! Have you noticed the window? I feel sad now. Because the duck is sad. Like... Nice, last way in.
Your place at the table.
Okay.
Tori usually sits here at dinner time.
It's sparkling!
You pick up the umbrella. You don't open it, though. No bad luck for you. This flower has seen better days. Well, something just take time.
Is there a secret here? Secret passageway? Please give me a secret passageway. No secret passageway.
Oh, these tools are finally getting some use.
Okay. Wait, one more time, just in case. Okay.
These are the same dusty old books from Toya's house in the underground. Ah, yes. 72 uses for snails. A classic. Getting everyone's belongings out of the underground was quite an undertaking. When the monsters got tired of carrying things, they started tossing stuff in the river. Then they just pick up their soaking junk all the way over at the core. Efficient and wet. There's still a lot of left down there.
Perfect for Undyne. Then she gets wet stuff and walks around without getting moisture. That's actually this mark. Wait. I picked up an umbrella, didn't I? Can I go back to the statue and put on the umbrella? As it said, do you lose your umbrella? I probably can. Anyways, let's continue.
You open up 70 uses for snails. You regret opening up 72 uses for snails. Lots of dusty old books from Toria's house in the ruins. Nothing like a nice book by the fireplace. Seems like fire sometimes lives here. Nothing like a nice book by the fireplace.
Aww. Toy sleeping.
Looks like Toy fell asleep while reading. Again. Like Toy fell asleep reading. Again.
Yeah. It's the ribbon!
The faded ribbon has been left out. You clip the faded ribbon. This is on the left, snacks on the right. This is on the left, snacks on the right.
Okay. It's just a sink. Excuse me then.
Shaking the sink again makes you feel strange. It's sort of a sinking feeling.
Oh!
Never apologize for art. It's still just a sink. It's still just a sink.
And one more time. Wow. What?
You're still shaking the sink, huh? You sure are sinking a lot of time into this.
Yeah.
But really, you should stop. Move along. Trust your instincts. Stop before these puns start going down the drain. No. It's a sink. It's a sink.
Okay. And one more time. Okay. It's a sink.
It's a shiny new fridge.
And that's all? We can open the sink.
Oh, this is on the left, next on the right. With you around, Tori is happily baking pies every day. It's an empty pie pan from today's pie. It's a brand new stove made right here on the surface. But Tori still just cooks everything with fire magic.
Tori, you should learn how to use the oven. Oh, she probably knows, but just doesn't like it.
Huh. One time, Tori tried to teach you how to cook with fire magic. But unfortunately, humans and magic still don't mix. It's a brand new stove made right here on the surface. But Tori still just cooks everything with fire magic.
It seems that it's gonna be the same thing. Yeah, one more time. Yeah, I guess there's nothing more than. I wonder if that. What is that? What is that above here? Like, what is that? I really don't know. Excuse me, I accidentally burped. It's a sink. Just double checking, you know. Anything behind the chair? No. Okay. Oh, Tori! You woke up.
Oh. Oh, hello, little one.
When you're ready to
say goodnight, let Tori know.
Well, I'm not ready. I need to talk to Blueky. Blueky! You're still here. I love you. I love you, man. Oh, you're still awake? I hope you aren't getting sick. I would offer you a good night hug, but, you know, sweet dreams, Frisk. Sweet dreams, you too. Enough stuff. I wonder if, which other characters are? Or maybe these are all the characters. Oh no. Oh. Ducky!
Oh. Ducky's crying because he missed you so much. You pet the duck and tell him everything will be alright. You pet the duck, and he still loves you.
I love you too, little duck. I love you too. But I have to go.
It's so heavy.
Okay, same. Oh, excuse, sorry. Hopefully this works, the umbrella thing.
You placed the umbrella atop the statue. Inside the statue, a music box begins to play.
I'm sorry, I'm a little emotional now.
The music box continues and doesn't stop. The music continues and doesn't stop.
Aww. Look at he's all tuckered out. Think that he will do the same thing. Wait.
Did he just wink at us? Oh, hey kid. Hey. Mr. Scared the Living Shit Out of Me? Or Mr. Flirter? Been a while, huh? Sorry we haven't been around too much lately. We just keep finding more and more weird junk down there. But hey, don't worry. We'll be done before you know it. I'll admit, it has been pretty exhausting work. But that's alright. Bro is happy. I'm happy. One second. I just got a message. Where's happy? I'm happy. Helping monsters. Yes. You're kind of all about that stuff, right, kid? On our last trip, we picked up this old rock for your mom. She doesn't know we found it yet. So don't go ruin the surprise. Guess the bros already headed back to New Snowden for the night. We'll be on the surface for a few days before we go back underground. Hey, wait a minute. Is it past your bedtime? Don't worry. I won't tell. Well, I'm going to get some fresh air. If you're still awake, feel free to come. Join me. Well, I'm going to get some fresh air now. If you're still awake, feel free to come and join me.
Aww. I will. Beautiful.
Ducky! The duck is crying because he missed you so much. You pet the duck and tell him everything will be alright. You pet the duck and he still loves you.
I love you too, little duck. Wait.
I will be back, my little duckling.
Sans wasn't the sparkle.
There's a long key sitting underneath this bench. You got the abandoned key. It's just a bench. Just a bench. Okay.
Sorry. love you, little pup. Hugs and kisses on the forehead. I will be back. Before I go to bed. Still awake? I hope you aren't getting sick. Oh no, I'm not getting sick. I just love talking to you. Sweet dreams, Frisk. Sweet dreams to you too, nap stuff. Well, Mr. Sense. Hey, glad you could make it. Did you know Grilby's daughter opened up her own late night place nearby? What? He's a father? Grilby's a father? What? Okay, I didn't know he was a father. I just answered the message. I just got a letter. I was thinking we head into town and drop by. Sounds good? Yeah, it is good. Cool. Yes, follow my lead. I know a shortcut. You always know a shortcut, don't ya? Hey! That's Fuku over the jukebox? Is that their name? It's livelier than I expected tonight. Fuku really brings in quite a nice life crowd. So your name is Fuku! Fuku! Cute name! Ah! Fuku! I like that name. Normally, I try to get here earlier in the evening. Always fun to play car with the wolves and pups. But they left already. It's a real doggone shame. What? You thought you were gonna make it through the night without some comedy gold? Don't let your guard down. I'm a generous guy. I had to wonder what good old Grilby is up to these days. He got out of the restaurant business right away and never looked back. Well, he probably took a well-deserved vacation, because I think he never took a break. Guess I'm glad he... The acorn didn't fall far from the tree. Hey, Fuku, can I get another round? What are you drinking? Are you drinking alcohol? Well, enjoy yourself, kid. Buy me food, please. Can I get some French fries? Miss Fuku, can I get some French fries? Why? I didn't think about it at first, but why is Undyne laying emotionless on the table?
Hey Frisk. Sorry you had to run into us like this. She'll be fine in the morning. Admittedly, this is kind of my fault. This seems to happen every time she wears that armor. She's excitable like that. I only asked her to try it on for, never mind the reason. Unimportant. Hey, don't look at me like that. I think it really brings out her inner,
Mark. Hey, fish. Did you know
that Elvis thinks my armor is oh hi? What? Frisk, really now? Don't mind her.
Like, really, really, really hot.
I'm dying, please.
Luke eyed the couple wearily. Yeah, she's clearly the hottest woman in the bar tonight.
Oh, yes. You think it's hot too, and fresh?
Don't encourage her. I guess we'll be here until the sun comes out. Don't worry about online. I'll get her home safe.
Night, first.
Well, as fun as that was, I'll see you at school tomorrow. I'm thinking we'll start with nap time.
Looks like Undyne
is out for the count. You poke her side. She groans incoherently.
Okay. She's clearly drunk. No, I wasn't. Okay. Nothing new.
Aww. This guy's cute. Yes, Mitsuku. I'll have it all cleaned up soon. Ah! Why does this keep happening?
Aww, poor you, Mr. or Miss. Aww, poor you. I would love to help you. Okay. I cannot put in the water can. Okay, it is the... Oh, what is this?
I can interact with it. You change up the music.
Okay, change up the music.
Nah. No.
Okay, you change up the music. Sorry, you change up the music. Okay, it seems that that's all the music. Leave. Yeah. I just went back to this music because this was the first music we came into. Let's see. Mr. River Person! La la la. Hello, little one. Have you been faring well? Tra-la-la. Humans, monsters, peace. Tra-la-la. I found games to play with the dogs. Tra-la-la. Beware of the man who speaks in hands.
What?
Tra-la-la. Humans, monsters, peace.
Tell me more about the man who speaks in hands. Is he here?
Nope. La la la, humans, monsters, peace. He's not gonna tell me.
This table seems to make a nice roost.
Roost? What do you mean? Wait. Oh, okay.
The slime kids are napping on the bar stools. You wonder what two children are doing at the bar in the middle of the night. Honestly, kids these days.
I myself am a kid. Okay, let's see.
Did you hear? I finally changed my name to Jimmy Hot Pants. I will be Ice Wolf no longer. Ice does not define me. It really is true. Every dog has his day.
You pat Jimmy on the head. Good doggo. Good doggo.
Good doggo.
Good doggo.
Oh, I'm playing podcast?
Hey! You're the kid who remember my name! You still remember it, right?
Hot Fire Guy. Yes, of course I remember it. Honey, please.
I have to call it back. There's a lot of yelling around going in here.
Hello, sweetheart? Did I lose you? Hello, sweetheart? Did I lose you? Yeah, you probably did.
Hello?
Oh, okay.
My hat is bigger than your hat! It's not! It's too! It's not!
This continues for quite some time. It continues.
I see a book. Can I interact with the book?
No, I didn't.
Oh well. Okay, letting that music be. I'm not gonna mix with anything more. Can I talk to you?
Luca kindly motions you to return to the other side of the counter. Aww, Luca politely directs your attention to the available seat in front of the counter. Luca gently turns you around and nudges you softly. Luca is not sure how to leave and looks very uncomfortable.
Okay, I will not make you any more uncomfortable.
Looks like there's a very sleepy boy on top of the river person's boat. But wait! Isn't that boat a cat? I mean, cats and dogs are getting along together. Long tonight?
Yeah. Think that way.
Fugu keeps her bar well stocked and tidy, just like her father did.
Can I have your alcohol? Well, enjoy yourself, kid. I'm not a boy.
You can't go through that fire exit because you're not made of fire!
Oh! Okay. I think that I can do anything more then. I wonder why the boards are like in color?
Miscellaneous cars and ships are scattered across the table. I guess the last guest didn't clean up after themselves.
No, I guess I don't think that. Well, I don't think there's anything more I can do, so. Oh, going home?
They definitely should get some sleep before school starts. In fact, they probably didn't really need to come to a bar at all.
Oops.
Good night, Frisk.
Sweet dreams. Napsta, you're still here. Have you been waiting for me?
Oh, you're still awake?
Yeah, you saw me as go, didn't you?
I hope you. Oh no, I'm not getting sick. Sweet dreams first. Sweet dreams to you too. That's that. Is there anything more to do now? Let's go tutorial. Wait! I did pick up a key, didn't I? Is it for this room? Room under renovations. Okay, not that key. Is it for... The abandoned key unlocks the door. Oh my gosh, there's so many plushies here. Aww, and pictures of
Shara or Kara and Asriel. Aww. What's happening here?
This royal subject is a friend to all. Even you, Prickly. Upon closer inspection, you realize this subject is not hugging voluntarily. Princess Kindred von Indred, the sixth has been impaled.
Oh no!
Truly a heartbreaking tragedy. We must inform the kingdom by dawn.
Aww.
Everyone's favorite cinder plant. You give the characters a very, very, very gentle hug. It's not like Cadence wants you to do that, fucker.
Everyone's favorite Cinderella plant. Fun fact, I have 3 small cactuses. Or cactars. You say cactars or cactuses too, if you have several. I have 3 of them.
Nothing but empty snail shells in here. Looking at the bucket longer fails to make it any less disgusting. Nothing but empty snail shells in here.
Okay. Can I talk to Oh no.
It's Toriel's diary. You read the open passage. Oh no. She's writing her own material now. What happens when 2 snails get in a fight? They slug it out. Mom, please. That doesn't even make sense. You flip to the beginning.
I brought a new diary today. From humans. Isn't that wonderful? We made a lot of progress in only a few months, but there's still much to be done. P.S. I also brought the most adorable stuffed animal. You flip through the pages. Frisk has settled in so well to their new life here. Each day, I'm even more proud. And that child seems to be quite a magnet for attention. Their friends rarely stray far. I hope this place can truly become a home for all of us.
You flip through the pages. I met with him today. Things were civil enough, I suppose. I'll admit, I enjoyed the tea more than the company. Being around him always brings bad memories. I'm trying so hard to start anew. He means well, in his own way. And while I'm not ready to let him in his home again, I hope this world can be a second chance for him too.
You flip through the pages.
I've heard amazing news. A new school will be soon open near the base of the mountain. Here, both humans and monster shire children will be able to learn together.
You flip through the pages.
It seems some monsters have founded their own settlement here. While I had hoped more of her would live among the humans, I understand that some will need more time than others to adapt. Changes will come, and we will get there eventually. Best of luck, New Snowden.
You flip through the pages.
Ow! A paper cut.
You flip through the pages.
Can you believe it, diary? In just a few days, I will begin a new journey, teaching at Ebert Elementary. Teaching has always been such a personal passion of mine. And here, I'll be helping monsters and humans grow closer all the while. One of Frisk's friends has been such a wonderful help with my preparations. She's so smart, and a real doctor. Would you believe it? Soon, I believe Frisk will join us there. Until then, I'm just glad they are safe and secure living here with me. P.S. For some reason, I purchased more stuffed animals.
You see, you flip through the pages. Today, my shawl asked me a very personal question.
Do you prefer butterscotch or cinnamon?
I had quite a laugh. All this time, I had never really thought about it for myself. I told them both were lovely.
You flip through the pages.
Some of Frisk's friends, the Skeleton Brothers and Undyne, are working on a new venture. They have been traveling to the underground and reclaiming abandoned monster property. I made a certain request to Sans. There was something I truly wanted, but was unable to find. With some luck, I believe he'll come through for me.
You love him. You love him. Oh my gosh.
You flip through the pages. Diary! You will never believe what has happened today. When I returned home from school, the most spectacular surprise party was sprung. You see, today is my birthday, and so many friends came to celebrate with me. I've never had such a crowd in my home before. We celebrated for hours, and my child even made me a butterscotch and cinnamon cake. Truly, I feel so much love here. These kind people are all a part of my family. Sorry. I know I'm getting a little emotional again. It's just
small tear stains sprinkle the page. You flip through the pages. There's a full year's worth of Toriel's personal anecdotes. It all culminates in
this found great deal on bulk order stuffed animals.
You return the diary to the state you found it in.
There's a sticky note next to the diary. Frisk, if you're reading this, please don't read my diary. Thanks, Mom.
Oops.
Sorry, Mom. I read your diary.
Toriel's writing chair. It's small and cramped, but she swears it helps her stay focused. Many, many bad jokes were written in this chair. It's Toriel's writing chair.
Here,
you're always safe from nightmares.
A bed fit for a queen,
and apparently, her royal subjects. Here, you're always safe from nightmares. Steadily, and with a little love, it's going to new heights. Wait a minute. You remove the price tag hooked to the wax leaf.
It's a fake plant? I thought it was a real plant.
Steadily, and with a little love, it's providing an affordable ambience to the bedroom.
One of Toriel's royal subjects. This is Archduke Edwin Justicar the Seventh. The bookshelf has recently been stocked with new surface literature. Texts about surface and subterranean plants alike now fills its shelves. Atop of the shelf,
liberal person, Vance the Fifth, reads his favorite novel. He spoiled the ending for you. How dare he? One of Toriel's royal subjects. This is Baroness Regalia Patentia the Second.
Love the names.
You peek inside. Goodness gracious! It's Toriel's sock drawer! Really now, who needs this many socks?
I do. I lose my socks every time and the washing machine is like, oh no 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 no! Oh, good socks! It does that all the time.
There she has so many socks. It's honestly a little bit concerning. You do you, Mom. It's Toria's abundantly supply of socks.
But she's not even wearing socks, right?
No?
No, she's not even wearing shoes.
This royal subject has no fear of the darkness beyond the window. Count Samuel Bravado III keeps the vigilant watch over his friends. No need to hide when it's dark outside.
Aww. Is that all? Is that all I can do? I want to... Well, I guess there's nothing more I can do in here then.
Did you see that? Shara's face just became red. Going. And now it's Frisk's face. I'm afraid. Is Shara in the house? Or Kara? I'm afraid. I'm just doing this again. And one more time. Well then, I shall continue. Well, I guess there's nothing more to do now, right? Besides being afraid that Char is in the game now, and that they will jump out at you, and maybe hide you. Well. Well, these human novels are truly quite charming. This is gonna be the last part now. Because there's nothing more to do now, and I hope you guys are having fun. Have had fun thus far. So, yeah. Let's continue. These human... I couldn't put this one down for so long. I must have dozed off. Toriel gazed down at you. Ah. That ribbon. You know, it looks lovely on you. Sometimes I can see so much of them in you. It's fine, Frisk. I know we've talked about this already. Watching you grow up. Here, on the surface. Well, you'll have to forgive this silly old lady for wondering how things might have been. But you know better than I do. Ever since the beginning, you've spent each and every day moving forward. I see your smile, and I feel so hopeful about our future here. Because I see you do it. I know deep down that I can too. You and all your wonderful friends, human and monster alike, will keep making the best of this beautiful world for as long as we can. Look at me, going on and on. This is hardly good material for a bedtime story. All right. Sweet child, it's awfully late, you know. Let's read, both read a nice story and have some pleasant dreams of our own.
Yes, Mom.
Well, that's the end of the game, I guess. Getting tucked into bed by Toriel and having sweet dreams and such. Well, thank you guys for being with me playing DREAMTALE. I hope you had a wonderful time watching me struggle. Though it wasn't much of a struggle, but I hope you guys enjoyed. Maybe I'll do one more game sometime soon. Anyways, thank you all for being with me throughout this story. And I wish you a good morning, good evening, good afternoon, or good night.